In the Fried Lab at Johns Hopkins University, we're really interested in studying protein folding. Why do we care about protein folding? Well, it turns out it's really important for understanding the underlying molecular basis for a lot of neurodegenerative diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's sort of go back to the basic biology of what's going on. So our cells are filled with these amazing molecules called proteins. And proteins are responsible for carrying out all the functions that our cells need in order to survive. In order to be able to perform their functions, proteins need to fold up into a really specific three-dimensional shape that we call the native conformation of the protein. But biochemists have long been interested in asking, how is it that proteins are so good at folding into such a specific conformation when there are millions and billions of other possible shapes that the molecule could exist in? So in order to interrogate that process, the experiment that has typically been done is to take a protein, unfold it so that you wind up with this more spaghetti-like disordered molecule that we call the unfolded protein, and then remove the force that unfolded it, thereby compelling it to return to its original conformation, which we would call refolding the protein. And it turns out that for small, simple proteins, they are really good at snapping back into their original shape, no matter what you did to unfold them in the first place. And that discovery was so important that Christian Amundsen won the Nobel Prize in the 1970s for describing it. But in our lab, we're really interested in studying the proteins that don't follow those rules, meaning that if you unfold them, rather than being good at snapping back to their native state, they instead fail to return to their original conformation, which we would call a misfolded state. And the reason why these misfolded states are so problematic is because oftentimes the protein doesn't completely fold back on itself, and it leaves these little ends that are sticky. And these sticky ends can cause lots of proteins to come together, ultimately forming these aggregates. Now, sometimes these aggregates are good. This is, for instance, what happens when you take an egg and scramble it. You notice that like you start with like a liquid egg that has all the different egg proteins, and they eventually become a solid. That's the scrambled egg. But when this same process happens inside your brain, and in particular, when we form aggregates that are called amyloids, these are believed to be associated with the wide range of neurodegenerative diseases that afflict an increasingly large number of Americans, like Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, etc. So in our lab, we're really interested in asking a fundamental question. Which proteins are good at following the rules and refolding, and which ones are more prone at forming these misfolded states? And we're also interested in asking, can we, by identifying the proteins that instead misbehave and go in this direction, can we design molecules that can intercept these misfolded proteins and thereby prevent them from forming these aggregates, which we know then go on to be associated with these disease states? And the focus that we're really interested in is it's long been possible to look at these aggregates, but our lab is really interested in looking at the thing that happens before that, which are these misfolded states. We feel that if we can identify these misfolded states and stop them, we can basically prevent the pathway that leads to neurodegeneration from happening in the first place by essentially stopping the process at an earlier state. So we really think there's a lot of reasons why understanding the rules that govern folding, what causes proteins to misfold, and stopping that with, for instance, future drugs, will have a lot of useful applications in the future.